Rick's Modern Morning Show, 11 minutes after the hour. Got your front page right here. Good morning.
Good morning, Ricky, and happy Monday, everyone. I'm Eva Marcil with a quick look at your headline news. Very scary storms moved across the South on Easter Sunday. At least 8 people are dead after tornadoes hit Mississippi, Louisiana, and Georgia on yesterday. We're keeping all of their families in our prayers. Also, over the weekend, deaths from the coronavirus in the U.S. passed 22,000. Ricky, that is the largest numbers of deaths in the entire world. According to a new report, several advisors, officials, and experts warned the government about the coronavirus a whole 6 weeks before Donald Trump took any action. And finally, check your bank accounts, everyone. The first round of stimulus checks have started to go out. Plus, there's a new online portal where low-income earners and those who aren't required to file taxes can sign up to receive their checks. Go to irs.gov and see what they can do for you. All right, that was a quick look at your headline news. For more on what's trending, log on to the Ricky Smiley Morning Show.com. Brock T, what's popping in sports, my brother?
I'm about to tell you there, Eva. Well, let's start off with the NBA Horse Challenge that aired this weekend on ESPN. A lot of former NBA players, current NBA players, former WNBA players, current WNBA players. Man, it's down to the final four competitors. Former NBA great Chauncey Billups, Utah Jazz point guard Mike Conley Jr., Chicago Bulls guard Zach LaVine, and Chicago Sky WNBA All-Star Ali Quigley remain four. So semifinals and championship airs this Thursday, April the 16th, 9 p.m. Eastern Time on ESPN. Let's talk about LeVar Ball, father of Lonzo, LiAngelo, and LaMelo. He says that he wants to start signing NBA and NFL players under his Big Baller brand, claiming that they're going to make up to $40 million on their first contract by giving them ownership and stock into their products, into the company, rather than just a fixed money up front. So we're going to see what happens with that. Last but not least, man, there's a rumor out there that Dallas Cowboys quarterback Dak Prescott had a birthday party for one of his friends at his house over the weekend. Teammate running back Ezekiel Elliott was allegedly there as well, and roughly over 30 people were in attendance. So this is not practicing social distancing. If this is true, it's not really safe right there, man. But that was the word out there that hit top news in sports over the weekend. Everybody was talking about it. So it is what it is, man. We got Gary with the team. What's up there, big y'all?
All right, Ricky, everybody. Are any of y'all TikToking yet? Has anybody started TikToking?
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure it out.
I haven't yet.
Y'all haven't yet? Ricky, have you TikToked?
My clock. That's about it.
Oh, this is clock. That figures. Well, everybody's raving about all the celebrities that's TikToking, and the latest ones to TikTok, y'all. They're saying Kevin Hart and his beautiful wife, Aniko, TikTok this weekend, y'all. They're saying that they were dancing to Michael Jackson's Thriller. Now, they're saying, y'all, as they practice their social distancing at home amid the corona pandemic. Now, they're saying, y'all, the date night hearts, honey, said, quote, I'm officially, oh, that's what Kevin said. He said, and she wanted to do one of these new dances. He said, I said, hell no, but let's show these young kids how it's done and what have you. And they were TikToking and stuff. And Kevin looked like Frankenstein, honey. I'm like, he did not get Thriller real good.
Okay, I can get down.
Yeah, but
that's the whole purpose for you to look like Frankenstein when you're doing Thriller.
Well, not the way he was doing it. Now, y'all have done it. You've done Thriller hell better than that. And
he got a bad back.
He does?
Yeah, remember he had that car accident, Gary?
Oh, that would. Oh, I thought it was because maybe it's the other woman. But anyway, yeah. Well, anyway, but he just.
Gary. Let's go on.
Anika, honey.
Oh, he's going to get you.
Anika,
I'm saving all the tapes. So when Kevin come on the show, I'm going to run all this stuff back. And you know Kevin is a personal friend of this morning show. And you've done a movie with Kevin, you still.
Oh, wow. But wow. I'm blaming on Corona. I didn't know what I was saying, Kevin.
Not that Rona. Everything's Corona fault.
Yes, right. But anyway.
Right,
yeah.
Brad.
But he did. Look, let me clear. He did fairly well. He did all right, though. But his wife looked much better doing it pregnant, y'all. So I guess you just follow. Is it a song that play and you just follow the song? Is that how you do it or whatever?
Because I have. Yeah, so a lot of these songs have dances that go along with them, and so you kind of learn the dance, and then you play the song, and you record it on the app called TikTok, and you know, record the family dancing. But not everybody's a good dancer, Gary. I mean, we've seen you dance.
Well, ain't good.
Anyway, not at all. No one has got the battle.
But anyway, congratulations to Kevin and Anika. She looks good pregnant, though. I'm surprised she was doing it pregnant, but she did it. So congratulations to them, y'all. All right, the Kahlua today, honey, is one of my favorite Kahluas. My Kahlua today, y'all, is cornmeal. On the high end, you say cornmeal, and on the low end, you say beautiful yellow. That's your Kahlua for the day.